Hi folks! In this video I'm going to show you how to make a simple map of archaeological sites in Libya using a shapefile layer of point data exported from the Amina database. And first of all, we're going to categorise the data in the layer by right-clicking on it and going to Properties. Then in the Style tab here on the left, we're going to click, instead of single symbol, categorized. And we'll choose to categorize based on the column called condition, which contains details about the condition assessment for the sites. If we click classify here, then you can see we have a range of values from destroyed, go through to good. So in order to make this map, we need to put these in a sensible order. So we'll have destroyed down at the bottom, going through to good at the top, through fair, poor, very bad, destroyed, unknown. Okay. And we'll put a color ramp on these, going from red to green. We'll click invert to make sure that our sites in good condition appear green and those that are destroyed in orange. We'll change the color of our unknowns to white and sites which are yet to be categorized can appear in black. So I'll click OK. And now we can see a representation of our data. Now we need to open a new Print Composer window. And we'll give it a name. In this case, we'll call it Libya. Click OK. Now we have a Print Composer window open. The first thing we need to do is to add a map window where we can view our data. So I'll click this Add New Map tool on the left-hand side here and drag a box over the representation of our A4 piece of paper. Okay, so there you can see the data appearing in the window. If we want to move that around, we can click this Move Item Content button on the left-hand side and we can drag the map around if we want to. If you want to change the size of the map as it's appearing in the window, we can alter this number here. If I lower the number, the map will get bigger. And if I increase the number, the map will get smaller. So one of the things that's useful to do is to add a scale bar to your map. And we do this by clicking on Layout and clicking Add Scale Bar, and then clicking in somewhere in the map where we want the scale bar to appear. In order to move items around within our Print Composer, we can use this Select tool on the left-hand side. And then we can move the scale bar around to how we like it. Another thing to do is to add a legend to our map. So again, we'll go to Layout and Add Legend. And again, we'll click in the map where we'd like the legend to appear. And if I click on the legend in my items view over here, we can see we have various items appearing in the legend. At the moment, it's set to auto update. But if we want to remove items from the legend, we can uncheck that box. Select, for example, OpenStreetMap and remove that from the legend. And we can remove also the administrative areas of Libya. So we just have our condition assessment appearing. If I want to remove For example, the uncategorized sites from the legend, I can click on that individual item of the legend and the minus button and remove that also. And then I could decide to go back to my layer inside properties and decide not to show the uncategorized sites, for example. Then if I go back to the map, I can click this refresh button to update the view. Also in the legend options, we can choose the different title of the legend. If I scroll down, I can expand the options for the background and change the background color. Finally, we'd like to add a north arrow to our map. And we'll do that by clicking this Add Picture button over on the left-hand side and drawing a box where I want my north arrow to appear. And then if I click on that picture, make sure I've selected item properties, and I click this arrow next to Search Directories, I'll then get a range of different images that I could add, some of them being north arrows. So I could just select a north arrow that I like the look of, and then that will appear. And again, using the select tool, I can move this around within the map. Okay, so there are many more options we could go into in more detail with this, but to keep it short, I won't say too much more. For example, scale by, you could have fewer segments, or you could change the units. You can increase the width of the lines in the scale bar if you like, or reduce it. There are lots more options in here, but the final step that I'm going to show you now is just how to export this map as an image. So you click on Export as Image, give the file a name, for example, Libya Condition Assessment, click on Save. And then you have this option to crop to content. And we can add about 10 pixels or so around our map content, and then click Save.